Good morning students, welcome to Sheba Group of School online class. Today we are going to discuss about the unit 21 crop production and management. In this we are going to learn about that is agriculture. Agricultural practice. Agriculture has many always been the backbone of our country economy. Ever since the Green Revolution, we have been cultivating different types of crops to cater the increasing demand. In our country, the following three categories of crops are grown. There are many types of crops, that is kharif crops, rabi crops, zadi crops, food crops, fodder crops, fiber crops, oil crops and ornamental crops. First one is a kharif crops. The crops which are sown in the rainy season, that is from June to September, are called kharif crops. Example, paddy, maize, soya bean, groundnut and cotton are the kharif crops. Next one is the rabi crops. The crops grown in winter season, that is from the October to March, are called rabi crops. For example of rabi crops are wheat, gram, pea, mustard and linseed. Zaid crops. The crops which are grown in summer season are called Zaid crops, that is muskmelon, watermelon and cucumber are the example of Zaid crop. Now we are going to learn about the utility crops are classified as food crops, fodder crops, fiber crops, oil crops, ornamental crops. First one is a food crops. Paddy and maize are cultivated for human consumption, that is food crops. These are useful for livestock consumption. Example, millets, that is a fodder crops. These are livestock consumption. Next one is the fiber crops. Fiber crops are used for cottage and textile. For example, cotton and hemp. Oil crops. Oil crops are useful in a large scale of consumption or industrial uses. For example, groundnut and sesame. Next one is the ornamental crops. These are utilized for a landscape gardening. Example, cotton and bougainvillea. Next one is the basic practice of crop production. Different activities in crop production are ploughing, sowing, applying fertilizer, harvesting and seed storage. All these activities collectively have an effect on the yield of crops. Soil preparation. The most important aspect in agriculture process is to lose the topsoil, that is the top soil. The loosened soil helps in the growth of earthworm and soil microbes. These organisms add humus to the soil and are friendly to farmers. Plant absorb water, minerals, nutrients and air from the soil through their roots. Hence, it is essential to prepare the soil in a proper way before starting the cultivation and practice. The soil preparation method are given below. That is ploughing. Ploughing or tending is the process of loosening and turning the soil up and down to facilitate the availability of nutrients in the root zone of the cultivating crops. Some few important agriculture implement generally used in the field preparations are ploughs. Plough is mainly used for tilling the soil to add fertilizer to the crop, remove weeds and other waste material from the field, and also to turn the soil. The plough is made of hood and is drawn by a pair of bulls or horses. It contains a strong and sharp triangular iron strip known as a ploughshare. The main part of the plough is a long log of wood which is called plough shaft. The other end is attached to a beam which is placed on a bull's neck. Next one is a hoe. It is simple tool which is used to till the land, remove weeds and dig up soil. It has a long wooden rod with a bent iron plate at one end. The other end may be attached to an animal. Next one is a cultivator. Cultivators are derived from tractor. Cultivator also kill weeds and dig up unwanted vegetation available in the field. Nowadays, ploughing is done by a tractor driver cultivator. The use of cultivator saves labor and time. Leveling. Once the field is ploughed, the topsoil is quite loose. The leveling of soil is done with the implement called the leveler, which is a heavy wooden or iron plank. Leaving of the field also help in uniform distribution of water during irrigation. Basal manuring. Basal manuring means adding manure to the soil. Manure contains many nutrients required for the growth of crop plant to increase the fertility of the soil. We add manure to the soil even before sowing because it gets properly incorporated into the soil. So, the application of green manure and farmyard manure will always enhance the growth and yield of the crops. Sowing of seed. This is the second step in the crop production. Once the soil preparation is over, sowing of the seed can be done. Sowing is the actual process of planting the seed in the soil. The seed that are sown have to be selected very carefully to have high quality. Various methods are followed for sowing the seed. They are sowing by hand. The scattering of seed by hand is the simplest method of sowing seed. So, this is the most economical method of sowing seed. Seed drilling. Seed drilling is a modern method of sowing seed. It is better and more efficient method than sowing by hand. It is usually done by attaching iron drills to a tractor, and seed drilling ensure that the seeds are planted at equal intervals and at the correct depth in the soil. So next one is the dibbling. It is a placement of seed material in a four pit or hole at a predetermined spacing with a dibble, more commonly by hands only. So soil around the hole is pressed with hand or leg for moist soil contact. And next one is the adding mature and fertilizer. Substance which are added to the soil in the form of nutrient to enhance the growth of plant are called manure and fertilizer. The term fertile refers to the inherent capacity of a soil to supply nutrient to crop. Plant in adequate amount and in suitable proportion. These nutrients are essential for the growth of plant. Manure is an organic substance obtained from the decomposition of plants or animal waste. And farmer dumps plants and animal waste in the pit open place and allow it to further decompose. The decomposed matter is used as a organic manure. Regular addition of organic manures helps to maintain the soil fertility, protecting them from wind and water erosion, and preventing nutrient losses through runoff and leaching. This also increases water holding capacity. Soil aggregation, soil aeration and pre-permeability. Then fertilizer is a substance which is added to the soil to improve the plant growth and yield. Fertilizer are composed of many of urea, ammonium sulfate and sulfur phosphate, potash and NPK. NPK means nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium. The use of synthetic fertilizer has significantly improved the quality of the food availability today. Although their long-term use is debated by environmentalists. Next one is the harvesting of crops. The process of cutting and gathering a crop is called harvesting. Different methods are used for harvesting. One is a manual harvesting, next mechanical method, and last one is the machine harvesting. Manual harvesting. Manual harvesting is the major method for harvesting in India. Certain crops are harvested without using tools. Crops like groundnut, green gram, black gram and horse gram can be harvested by uprooting with hands only, provided soil moist is adequate for hand pulling. Next one is the mechanical method. Harvesting in our country is generally done by employing the laborers with the help of farm instrument like sickle. This method is a laborious and time consuming one, and it is suitable for small size farmers only. And last one is the machine harvesting. This harvesting method is used in large sized agriculture field. The term harvesting also includes the immediate post harvest practice, such as like a thrashing and winnowing. The process of separating the grains from the chaff or pods is thrashing. After thrashing, we must separate the grain from the chaff. Winnowing is the process of separating the grain. Okay students, I hope that you all are understand today video class. I will see you in the next class. Thank you.